it was my extraordinary privilege to have played a role in one of the epic dramas of our age, America's race to the moon and back. President Biden and Vice President and Chair of the National Space Council, Harris, now join a distinguished train of visionary leaders. As President John F. Kennedy so inspiringly said at Rice University, "We choose to go to the moon. We choose to go to the moon in this decade and do the other things, not because they are easy, but because they are hard. Because that goal will serve to organize and measure the best of our energy and skills. Because that challenge is one that we are willing to accept, one that we are unwilling to postpone, and one which we intend to win, and the others too. We planted the American flag on the moon. We did so not to lay an imperial claim to the moon. As idealistic Americans, we came in peace for all mankind. Now let us salute the memories of those who so heroically sacrificed their lives for the achievement of an impossible dream. On behalf of all of the early space pioneers, let us now tip our helmets to our heroic and worthy successors, President Biden and Vice President Harris, NASA Administrator, U.S. Senator and fellow astronaut Bill Nelson, Deputy Administrator Pam Melroy, and Associate Administrator Robert D. Cabana. We also recognize the work of General Lester Lyles and James J. Miller, Executive Secretary of the Space Council, UAG. Let me also salute the achievements of human exploration of space by private enterprise with the support of the U.S. government, especially those who aspire to send people past the Kármán line, and especially we salute the young men and women astronauts, scientists, and technicians now picking up the torch of deep space exploration. The return to the moon via the inspiring Artemis project, laying the groundwork for the colonization of the moon, a giant leap toward Mars. And if the imagination, intrepidness, and courage of the American people for space continues apace onto the exoplanets of our stars. Thank you, and God bless America, Earth, our galaxy, universe, and the celestial metaverse. It is our mutual high privilege to explore.